Hello friends, this is a continuation of the chapter Number Systems of class 9. Okay, now we will go to the first problem. Find the decimal expansion of 10 by 3. That is what we have to divide 10 by 3. So I'll write 10 inside and 3 outside. 10, 3 will go in 10, 3 times, 3, 3's are 9, the remainder is 1. Add a 0 here, it becomes 0. 3, then again it is 9, remainder is 1, so on. My 3.33 is the 3 gets on recurring, the 3 goes on repeating. Okay, so 10 by 3 is equals to 3.333, or the other words I can say 1 by 3 is equals to 0.333 or 0.3 bar. Now I put a bar above 3 showing that the number 3 is recurring. Okay, so in this decimal 1 by 3, the remainder never becomes 0. It goes on, the remainder always comes to be as 1. There is no 0. Such kind of numbers are said to be non-terminating. Non-terminating means they do not terminate, or in other words, they do not end. So they are called non-terminating and recurring. What is recurring? This point 3 is continuously recurring, isn't it? So such kind of decimals are called non-terminating and recurring. Now let us take another example. That is 7 by 8. Now 7, this will not go in 7. So I will put a point here and a 0 here. This will go in this 8 times, it is 64, the remainder is 6. Once again I put 7 times, it goes 56, the remainder is 440. So now the answer for 7 by 8 is 0.875. Okay, in this case we get the remainder as 0. So in 7 by 8, the remainder becomes 0. This number is called terminating. I hope you get it. The earlier example, it was non-terminating and recurring. Whereas in this case, the division stops at one point. When the remainder is zero, the division stops. So such kind of numbers are called terminating. So for any given fraction, there are only two conditions. Either it will be terminating or it will be non-terminating and recurring. Now let us do one problem. 1 into 11, isn't it? This will not go in this. So we will put a 0. Now still it is not possible. So we put a 0 over here. 11 will go in this 9 times. So it is 99. It is 0. It is not... It doesn't come. Once again we will add another 0, so it goes in this 9 times, that is 99, and once again. So what do we see? 1 by 11 is equals to 0.09.09, or in other words it is equals to 0.09 bar. I hope you get it. Okay, so this 0.09 comes on recurring. So such kind of numbers are called non-terminating, recurring. I hope you get it. Non-terminating and recurring. What is recurring here, or what is repeating here? 0.09. And why do I say it's non-terminating? Because the remainder never comes to zero. Okay. Now let us take this example. 36 divided by 100. First I'll have... It will go in this 3 times. So it is, I get the remainder 60. It will go in this 600 times. Now I got this 0. Therefore this is nothing but 0.36. Whereas this is of the type terminating. I hope you understood it. So given any decimal, given any fraction, these are the two conditions. The number can be any one of the two conditions. Okay. I hope you understand. Okay, now we'll go to the next problem. That is, you have to express 1 minute, we'll see. Yes, we will take this problem. Show 0.333, which is nothing but 0.3 bar, can be expressed in the form P by Q. You have to express this decimal 0.3 bar in a fraction form P by Q, where P and Q are integers and Q is not equal to 0. So we have to express this decimal number into a fraction, okay, or a rational number. To be more precise, I have to express it as a rational number, okay. Now what is it is, let x is equals to 0.333. So now let me assume this given number as x. Now I'll multiply it with 10, I'll get 10x. 10x is equals to 3.333, okay. Now I'll subtract equation 1 from equation 2. That is 10x minus x is equals to 3.333 minus 0.333. I hope you get it. 10x minus x is equals to 3.3 bar minus 0.3 bar. Okay. So I get 9x equal to this part will get subtracted. This 0.3 bar from here and 0.3 bar will get subtracted. And I'll have only 3. So x is equals to 3 by 9, which is equals to 1 by 3. I hope you understood. You will be given such problems. So this is one of the important problems. So students, understand this thoroughly. Whatever number is given, you take it as x. Now bring one number to this side. Now how can I bring one number to this side? By multiplying with 10. Then subtract the first equation from the second equation, and you will get the answer. Okay. Now this is how we solve such kind of problems. Now we will take another example, that is express 1.27 bar in the form of P by Q, where P and Q are integers and Q is not equal to 0. Now let us assume the given number as x is equals to 1.2727 and 27, okay. Since two digits are repeating, in the previous problem 0.3, which was a single digit, it was repeating, whereas here two digits are repeating, 0.27. So whenever two digits are repeating, we will multiply them by 100. When one digit is repeating, we will multiply it by 10. I hope these are certain points which you have to keep it in mind. Otherwise, this problem is very, very easy. Okay. So since two digits are repeating, we will multiply x by 100. So we will get 100x is equals to 127. These two numbers will come to this side. When I multiply by 100, these two digits will come to this side. It will be 127.27727. Okay. So when I subtract both these equations, I get 100x minus x is 99x, and 127.27 bar minus 1.27 bar. 27 bar and 27 bar will get cut. 127 minus 1 is 126. I hope you get it. Therefore, x is equals to 126 by 99. This can be further divided by 3. I'll get 42 by 33. Once again, it will get divided by 3. It will be 14 by 11. I hope you understood how we got the answer. So, whatever number is given, we will assume it to be as x. Then, what is the block that is getting repeated? Is it a single digit? Is it a two digit? Or is it a three digit? If it is a two digit, we will multiply by 100. If three numbers are getting repeated again and again, we will multiply it by 1000. Then you have to subtract, okay? You have to subtract the first equation from the second. Then the rest you can do, which is not difficult, okay? Now we will see another problem in this. There is a little twist to this problem. That is why I had written it for you all. 0.235. Here you will see that 2 is constant, whereas the block 35 is repeating. Okay, so first what you should do is, you should bring the 2 to this side. Once you bring the 2 to this side, then you can bring 35 to this side. Okay, I hope you get it. So let us first assume now here 2 does not repeat, but the block 35 repeats. Okay, so what we'll do is we will take x is equals to 0.235, where 35 is repeating. Now we will multiply it by 10. We'll get 2.35. I hope you get it. We get 2.35 bar. Okay, now that we'll mark it as the first equation. See, earlier we used to mark the x as the first equation, but since 2 does not repeat, I will bring my 2 to this side and make that as the first equation. So please keep that in mind. 10x is equals to 2.35. Now these two numbers are only repeating. So with what will you multiply? I'll multiply it with another 10, or I'll multiply this equation with 100. You can think about it that way also. Okay. So I multiply it by 100. I get 100x is equal. I multiply the first equation. Okay. So I get. What do I get? I get it as 235.35 bar. Subtract 1 from 2. I get 100x minus 10x is 990. 235.35 bar minus 2.35 bar is 233. So x is equals to 233 by 990. I hope you understood this well. Okay, so this is how we solve problems where we are asked to write it in the form p by q, where p and q are integers and q is not equal to 0. Okay, now we go to the next problem, that is, looking at a given fraction, can we say whether they are terminating or non-terminating and recurring? When you are given a fraction, let it be like 1 by 3, 1 by 7 or 7 by 8. Looking at it, can you tell whether it is a terminating fraction or a non-terminating recurring fraction? Okay, we can tell, yes. If the denominator of the rational numbers are in the form 2 power m into 5 power n, where m and n are integers. So if you are able, you have to look at the denominator. If the denominator is of the form 2 power m into 5 power n, then we can say that this number is a terminating fraction. Now let us take this case 2 by 5. Here the denominator 5 is of the form 5 to the power 1. Therefore, this is a terminating fraction. Let us take 1 by 10. 1 by 10 can be written as 1 by 2 into 5. So, once again, this is a terminating fraction. Now, let us consider this fraction 1 by 3. This is not of the form 2 power m into 5 power n. Hence, it is a non-terminating recurring fraction. So, only it can be if the denominator is a multiple of 5, or it is a multiple of 2, or both 2 and 5, then we can say that it is a terminating fraction. Now 5 by 7, 7 cannot be written in the form as a multiple of 2 and 5. Hence it is a non-terminating and recurring fraction. I hope all of you understood this. Thank you, friends.